Hello Scorpio, welcome to my channel, The Mother Speaks Tarot. My name is Allison. My channel is new, so please subscribe and hit the bell button. Also like, comment, share, all of that would be so very much appreciated. Thank you so much. I'm also an author. I'm writing an action-adventure series based on twin flames. It's also based on my life and my twin flame's life. You can find links to purchase the two novels in the series that I have already written on my About section here on YouTube, as well as links to view the trailers that I made for each of them. This reading is timeless. This means that is correct for you. It is correct for you whenever you come across it. This is the Celtic cross spread, which I read slightly differently than others, so I will explain as I go. At the center of everything for you at this time, Scorpio, we have the Queen of Swords. Now, that's a pretty heavy energy to start off with right away, a queen. Okay, man or woman, a queen, this feminine energy is very powerful. And she is beginning to manifest in your life. The Queen of Swords, see, okay, let me explain that. When a card is upside down, for me, that means the energy is there, but it has not fully manifested yet. It is beginning to come into being, okay? Now, this could be a Libra that is beginning to manifest into your life. It doesn't have to. It could just be the energy of you mastering your mind, mastering the power of communication, which is what the Queen of Swords does. This is a feminine energy that has learned through pain. She's gone through a great deal of pain and suffering, and she's gained wisdom from it. She's mastered her mind. Out of all the cards in the deck, she is the mastermind. Okay? This is a person able to communicate correctly. That's funny how it just, with oratory skills, clear communication, clear thoughts. She can speak her mind very well. Sometimes she can be a little too harsh. Okay? This is brutal honesty. Okay? So this energy is manifesting into your life right now. Okay? Now, I always try to point out when I get this card for people that in other decks, the Queen of Swords is sitting on her throne with her sword up and her hand out as if to protect herself. This particular queen is very different. You'll see this looks like an old man, okay? What she's done is she has cut away old, outdated thoughts and ways of thinking that she doesn't need anymore. She doesn't need to be on guard. She doesn't need to hold her sword up, which is the Ace of Swords. Okay? She doesn't need to protect herself anymore. She's relaxed. She's so relaxed, she doesn't care very much about covering her top. She is who she is. And she is, she's cut out the things in her life, even like ego, that don't serve her anymore. To me, this head is very much like Kali, the goddess Kali, where she wears a necklace of skulls, and those are all aspects of her ego that she has cut away. The next card that we read is the energy that is directly influencing this budding ability to speak your mind. And this is cup energy. This is your energy. In particular, Cancerian energy, and also the moon, which is Pisces. So these are your counterparts in the water. That Scorpio is Pisces and Cancer. So this is like all three of you in one for me right now. That's what I'm feeling. This Four of Cups is all about stagnation. Okay. Boredom. You'll see that it says luxury. Now, I feel like there's something hidden from you. Okay, now the moon brings things to light from the dark. Okay, and I'm feeling that it's shedding this light on these cups right now. And down here, you don't seem to have a very solid foundation. Even though you may be experiencing luxury, your emotions are not flowing as they should. The moon can be a bit deceptive because it only shines because the sun is shining on it. It doesn't have its own source of illumination, but it does illuminate things, but it does it in a kind of a deceptive way. And so what I'm feeling that is this stagnation that you're going through in your life is going to, once you focus on the fact that you are feeling this stagnation in your own energy, your own water energy, Scorpio, you're going to realize why. And that's the moon effect going on right now. Okay? Because this is an earth and water card. And when you mix earth and water, you get mud, and it doesn't flow like water does. It's not crystal clear. It doesn't sparkle. Okay? And so this is disappointment and disillusionment. This is when you're despondent, you're bored. Okay? Now, the next card that we read is what is at the root of everything that's going on for you at this time, Scorpio. And here you have your own energy, right? There's Scorpio right there. And you also have Venus, which is love. And this is the number that the world was built upon. Now, so this is telling me that your world is built upon choices and daydreams and fantasies, okay? Because that's what this represents. Daydreams, fantasies, our heart's desires. Okay, our imagination. But this card tells you that your reality is different from our airbrushed, fondest dreams. Okay, now it could be that you have a lot of options, that you have a lot of choices, but that's not exactly what I'm feeling for you right now. I'm feeling that this stagnation, this not being able to communicate very your truth very well, is because your world, the root of everything. Seven is the number the world was built on. Your world is built on daydreams and fantasies, and you have to realize that reality is different from your dreams. Our dreams, that's what I meant by airbrushed. Our dreams are just that. They are fantasies. And I think what you have to do is be a little bit more realistic with what your world is built upon, because four is the number of stability. And yet, this doesn't look very stable. It looks very whimsical. Okay? The four of discs is the foundation, a solid foundation, whereas this is not very solid looking. Okay, it just looks whimsical. And I'm being told also to let you know that you have options. There are other choices that you can make. Okay, so the next card that we read is the energy that is moving out of your life. And here is the Five of Swords. And we have swords next to swords. Okay, they're all on the same level. You have a sword here, you've got a sword here, and you've got a sword over here, which I'll get into later. Straight across. Okay, so I feel like they have a lot to do with one another. This is a defeat that did not happen. Okay, this is when it's right side up. I don't know if it might have something to do with an Aquarius, but again, we have Venus. And as I said, four is the number of stability. Five is the number, the one extra it is what brings instability to your stability. Okay. This defeat, this conflict never happened. This is the card of a bad conflict. like an unfair battle. False gossip, rumor, trickery, deceit, trying to get one up on another. Cheating. Okay? So I just feel like this was just kind of a worry that this was going to happen. And it just never did. So this is actually a really great thing to have in your energy that is moving out of your life right now. Okay? So if you were expecting some sort of terrible conflict, it never happened. And it's on your way out, so it won't be happening. I mean, this energy can always come back in. But the universe is telling you right here that this is on its way out. Okay? Because the next two cards look pretty flipping good. All right? The next two cards that we read are two future cards for me as a reader. This is a more immediate future, whereas this is a future that will happen a little further out. This will happen after this one. And this and they both happen after this one, which is the outcome, but we'll get to that in a minute, okay? Now, here we have a major arcana card in your not so immediate future, and it is right side up. This will happen. This is a fully manifested energy, okay? And this is the Chariot. This is victory. This is a victory that the universe is something you were supposed to have. Now, this is a major arcana card, and when I get major arcana cards, that means to me as a reader that this is something that is happening to you because of your divine blueprint. Your divine blueprint is the reason why you are here, incarnated as the person you are on this planet, in this dimension. You are divinity learning something, and this is part of the reason why. And this victory is part of your divine blueprint, the reason why you're here. Achieving this victory is something that is meant for you. This could have something to do with a Cancer. It doesn't have to. Now, the thing with this knight here is that he has to really control these sphinxes here. It can be hard because they go in different, look at how they're looking in different ways, okay? In other card decks, he's got two horses and they're both going two different directions. And so it might take a while for this victory to get there. But when it does, it's going to be full on. And this one is meant for you. There is a beautiful victory coming. And this victory comes after this new beginning. Okay? All aces are a new beginning. And this is the Ace of Wands. And wands have to do with work. This could be a new career for you, a new job. But this is also passion. This is energy itself. This is the divine spark that gets something going. Okay? This kickstarts creation. Okay? This is an explosive drive that begins and fuels a creation. Okay? This is an idea so powerful that it ignites a new idea, a new sense of self sometimes. This is raw, untapped energy that is required to keep things moving. The energy to keep your chariot coming in. Okay? This is telling you that you have all the energy that you need to do what you need to get this victory, which is already ready for you to bring in. It's fully manifested. You have everything you need to bring it in. And after such stagnation and a foundation built on fantasy, this new beginning is exactly what you need to have the true life that you fantasize about. Your fantasies, your dreams, they can become true. For real. It's just that here in life we have to put in the energy and sometimes the work that is required to bring in these victories. If we just see, this could be sitting around. If we just sit around, we get stagnant. We have to get up and do it. Okay? This is what I'm being told to tell you. And you have everything you need to bring it in. And it won't be half as scary as you might think. Because here is your hope. Another queen who's trying to manifest for you. You see this? Queens are creative energy. Both of your queens are upside down. This means that the energy is there. Queens, feminine energy, is fertile energy. You need fertility for things to grow. When you plant a seed, you have to have fertile soil. You have the fertile soil. Do you see what I'm saying? You are learning how to communicate and clarify your mind, to control your mind. And here, you are hoping to have the energy required for your new beginning. That's why these two are of the same suit. This is what you need. This is your energy. This is what will come from it, along with your victory, that will bring the victory. This queen looks like victory itself, doesn't she? She is also very calm. She's built her empire. She's the queen of her kingdom. She shines like the sun. The sun is the happiest card in the deck. She is happy. She is sexual. She is sensual. She is a nurturer. She is passionate. She is beautiful. She is in charge. This is somebody enjoying their best life. This is someone who has come out of their shell. And cancers are in their shell. That's not what I'm saying. What I'm saying is that's the message here with the cancer. Come out of your shell. Come out of your shell. And become this beautiful, beautiful, successful energy. Doesn't matter if you're a man or a woman. This is fertile, powerful energy. Now this is your environment. In other decks, this is called strength. So I think that your strength is building. Okay? It's upside down, so it's not fully manifested. If this was like this, I would say, oh my gosh, Scorpio, you are being so strong. But you're just now learning that you have the power. You're just now learning to clarify your mind and learning how to communicate to get yourself out of this stagnation. Okay? Now, having these two together, this says lust. Now, there's people that have a lust for life, okay? And you'll notice that this is a woman and a cat, a lion and a cheetah. And they both of these feminine energies are very relaxed looking. All of these feminine energies are very relaxed because they know that they've done it. They know that they're in control. And this could lead you to, I have to say it, this could lead you to a very sexually satisfying relationship. The Queen of Wands is the act of sex itself. And this is saying lust. And when I get this card, I don't usually refer to the lust part of it. But seeing them next to each other, this is telling me that since she's your hope card, and she's upside down, and she is also upside down, I think you're hoping for a very sexually satisfying relationship. This could have something to do with a Leo. This is Leo's card. This is a major arcana card. Okay? This is your environment. This is going on right now. You're not being as strong or as lusty as you want to be. Okay? Now here's your fear card. Here's another feminine energy, but this feminine energy is the formation of ideas into a plan. This is bringing your ideas into reality. Okay? So I'm thinking that because what we have here, these two swords, you don't know how to bring your plan into reality. You don't know how to get it there just yet, but you will. Okay? This is a fully manifested energy. And sometimes this means the anger of the gods. So you might be afraid of a feminine energy in your life who has a sharp tongue because of this blade here. You might be afraid that this feminine energy might get angry at you if you try to go ahead and find this happiness you're looking for. If you get this new beginning that will bring you to your victory. Okay? Getting a little long here. So the next card that we read is the outcome, and this is change. This is a huge change. This is another major arcana card. Tower moments happen all the time. And I think what is, sometimes it's as simple as like, you know what, I don't like peanut butter, I'm going to stop eating it. And then for the rest of your life, you don't eat peanut butter anymore. And it seems like a small change, but it's actually a tower moment. There's something in your life that is making you stagnant. You're going to realize now, because this is a fully manifested energy, something big is going to change. A tower is going to fall. Something is going to get illuminated. The things that don't make you happy are going to illuminate for you finally through the moon. It's going to show you. Remember when I said it's the moon is going to show you what is making you not happy, what is making you not stable. This is going, it's saying, and the moon is very intuitive. You're going to have to listen to your intuition. You are the most intuitive sign in the zodiac, Scorpio. So you already know what it is. That's why this is a fully manifested energy. Okay? And what's going to happen? The underlying energy is the lovers. You're going to have that hot, sexually satisfying relationship that you're looking for. When you just act on what you really want in life. When you really figure it out. When you learn how to speak your truth with the Queen of Swords. When you learn how to harness your power as the Queen of Wands has. You're going to have everything that you've been looking for. And I gauge the amount of control that you have over this issue by the number of major arcana cards to minor arcana cards. And you have 1, 2, and 3. 3 out of 10 cards means that you are really in control here. This victory is meant for you to happen. That's why it's a major arcana card. It's a message from the divine. The divine is telling you it's okay to be strong enough to look for what brings you sexual satisfaction. And this tower says, this tower moment is supposed to happen. You're supposed to tear down this tower that isn't making you happy anymore. This tower of unstable cups that is making you bored. All right, Scorpio, this was a powerful reading. I hope that it resonated for you. See you next time.